Hello guys and welcome to episode 33 of my Rome 2 Total War campaign with the Iceni tribe. Today we're going to be taking on the Romans and hopefully finishing off the Etruscan League. Now I have got an army all the way down here which has been moved, and this was basically going to go and attack Carolus as soon as it gets there. We've got these two armies here that will deal with this navy of the Romans, so that we can take Alilia for ourselves eventually. And then we've got an army that's basically right next to Consentia, so we can take that as well. We've got so many agents over here, but the Etruscans are trying to take out the Roman the Romans, and the Romans are trying to take out the Etruscans. My druids are standing here watching it all go by, which is quite funny. Now, last turn, Ariminum was successfully warded by my army here, so the Etruscans didn't try and attack that, so they're left in that area there. But we've got plenty of money to spend, so I'm gonna go and try and spend it around the map, and I might do so by increasing some of these settlements that I know I can get away with, because for instance this province has, Aquitania has 10 plus 10 public order per turn. I can upgrade both of these settlements to barbarian small towns, and they will provide or cause -4 public order per turn, so I can get away with making both of these. I could also go up for a barbarian 100, but these are, I don't think I've teched up for this yet, so I can't upgrade those. So I think I might go ahead and get a barbarian town for gold. That doesn't actually cause any squalor, so I may as well get that, but it costs 4,000 gold to make, which is a good way to use my money, I guess. And then a barbarian small town here. Alright, let's see where else we can do it. Not there, because obviously Big Recti and Celtica I've only just got the men out of. Last thing I want to do there is mess that up again. I can upgrade this town to get me some money from olive oil. Over here, we got plus 12. We can upgrade maybe Araculum or Brigantium. Probably do both of them, I think. If it's plus 12, get some extra marble. Awesome. So we're down to 2,600 gold. I think that's enough. Just upgrading the cities all over the map. Oh, there are more villages upgrading to towns, but yeah, that's how it's going to be. And let's have a look at our druids. Sage of the forest. So this guy, busy converting the culture over here. Now that we've killed the agent that was trying to convert back, it should be in my favor again. The Iron Winds are the ones over by Corsica. How can I help? And the Will of Andrasta. They're sitting in Carduba, dealing with the public order. We've got the Burning Men. I'm going to put them to a normal stance, and we're going to try and get them on land somewhere. I don't think I can because of all of the armies dotted around. Quite annoying. Okay.
Is a dangerous course.
And of course we have the Warlord in here. Now, a couple of our Warlords have died now, so I'm probably going to start recruiting more at some point, but not this turn. I'm going to move straight on to the next turn so we can declare war on Rome. Tribal totem will be finished in 3 turns, allowing me to make taverns, which will allow me further to make painted ones, which are basically meaning more elite troops, which would be pretty cool to have. Let's click that end turn button.
Our merchants are welcomed across all the world for the wealth they bring. Why should your lands be any different?
Well, this trade agreement's worth 536. They're only asking me for 260. Think that's fine by me.
Will you not give our people a little gold? You have much, and our people do not wish to become the slaves of envy.
Wow. The Odorician kingdom has become quite big. They control, I think, all of Thracia. They control most of Macedonia. And they're going into Illyria. Interesting stuff. I think I might make an non-aggression pact with these guys because it... Somebody asked me in the comments of the last video to make allies around the map so that I could, you know, have an ally which I could rely on and we could have the same goal and actually have, like, battles where I have reinforcements from my ally. And it's a nice idea, so I'll try getting it going with a non-aggression pact, but I'm not sure how long that will last or whether the Orisian or Odorisian kingdom will actually last that long. Selikorix has been found. Katios has increased in ranked. Awesome. He's going to be... Gonna make him a dignitary. Plus 5% critical chance of success in all actions. How can I gonna use this spy to try and kill this guy with poison. 87% chance. Ah, we wounded him. That'll do. Nicely done there, scout.
Hail to the mother. How can I
right,
help?
What next? Let's declare war on the Romans. So, we're gonna get this guy into normal stance. We're going to attack Carolus this turn. We're going to
for the tribe!
Attack this navy and take Alelia.
Attack!
Declare war on the Romans. Nice. Expansionist and devious.
Prepare yeah. for battle!
We're gonna beat back this army. Just gonna auto-resolve this. With, let's see, aggressive stance. Doesn't really make much of a difference.
We still have a win.
Got a navy that finally increased in rank. And we're gonna make him a warrior. So we can get the charge bonus for boats. We're going to make this army attack Alelia.
You show a strong will. The port is now blockaded. Good.
And we're going to attack and take this city for ourselves with a sea landing. I haven't done this much before, I don't think. So, let's go ahead and fight it on the battle map. Just going to quick save first in case it crashes. So for those of you who've wanted to see a sea battle, well, now's your chance really, because this is a sea battle as it's going to get. I'm going to get my transports with the sword band to go and look for their two defensive boats. And in the meantime, get the rest of my sword band over here so they can land together in one big clump and then I can build them up and just... basically throw them at the enemy in one big clump. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with the cavalry because they don't actually come with horses when they attack with boats. And the ballistas don't come with ballistas either, so I can't make use of them. So they'll probably come in after somewhere.
Transport ships.
And then I've got the general and some chariots, which don't have the chariots. Okay, so that'll do. Oh, they're too... boats are here. I'm going to break off a couple of these guys.
Our reinforcements
and these two over here can land in the middle of the settlement. I think that'll be fine. We'll get the rest of these guys. Go land on the beach just here. All right. Get the skirmishers to land as well.
Transport!
And hopefully get pretty much everything to land on the left there.
Transport ready.
I'll start sailing over there as well with my general. Alright, well, I don't know what's happening here. But we're going to try and board that. They're just ramming this boat, and I'm probably going to end up losing a unit if I'm not careful. Because this is the thing with AI and boat battles. The AI is extremely efficient in boat battles. Whereas basically, see, look, they've just ran that. And what am I supposed to do about that? It just makes no sense. My boat bugged out while their boats don't, and it's pointless. It really annoys me sometimes. So that's why I don't do many boat battles. And it's not because I'm bad at boat battles, before anyone says. It's just that they are broken. Literally broken. So like here, like, why are my men not charging onto their ship, even though I told them to board already? You know? It's and now they're just getting free killed because they're bugging out. It's just broken. It really is. It's basically like a land battle on sea. Pretty much all it is. Getting this navy to go land where they can. They're only like levy freemen on boats, so not really going to end up doing much. We should win this melee though on this ship and hopefully take out one of them at least. It really depends if these men over here actually do a lot of damage with their spears or javelins. I just really, really hate sea battles. And my men just don't. Your men just don't do what you tell them to. And then they get themselves killed by the AI, who knows perfectly what to do and is absolutely perfect at sea battles, but crap at land battles. It's like they spent all their time doing the AI of sea battles and not AI of land battles. Because sea battles are genuinely hard. I'm not going to lie. Right, I need another ship of something that can go and take out this last ship, because they've actually won that somehow. Alright, we've got some sword band here. They should be able to take care of themselves. And we've got the rest of our melee troops running in from this side. So we're running now towards them with our sword band. We're just going to rip down all these tents. I really don't get this. This is another thing that really bugs me. Like, the first few men run through the tents and they jump over the stalls, and then the other ones just run through them and run them down. It's like, why? Why do you do that? We pretty much just killed that levy skirmisher unit, so we're going to continue to charge forwards into the mob and the other levy skirmisher unit. These two units alone will end up taking down their whole army at this rate. So, I'm going to set them to boarding mode, and hopefully they can take care of the ship. If not, then it's just fudged. Keep the sword band moving. And over here, let's see how the veteran riders do on foot versus the levy skirmishers on the boat. Okay. Engage properly over there.
Strappers ready!
The enemy singer's dead. We're going to charge into the back of this Italian noble cavalry. They're not going to really get the chance to charge me, so I can just sort of surround that unit and hopefully kill it off a little bit. All these units that got caught. Only 52 got out alive from that. So he did a big blow there, just because they just chose not to attack me. Over here we've hit some Italian spearmen with my own spearmen and some sword band. Pretty much got left only my crappy units now over here. Some skirmishers, all my horses without horses. The ballistas are bugged, so they can't even get off the ship. We managed to kill, thank God, this last unit on the boat. It is. I don't know. I just want to like facepalm forever after this battle.
We'll kill them all. Melee fighters. Brutals.
Oh, come on, men. You can take down these horses. Doing well. This is their general. And we're engaged pretty much with every one of their other troops over here in a large melee. Which is actually pretty cool. It's lasting longer than usual. Both sides are still pretty much full morale. As I say, that one drops a little bit. I'm not even sure if all my men are attacking there, that's the thing. So let's charge them all forwards and try and get them all into like attacking mode. All doing a little head bob. Cool. Kill the general. Let's go charge into the back of them with the rest of my sword band. Got some reinforcement navy freemen coming in here. These are the guys off the ships. They only come in groups of 80 because they're the ship units. We're carving down well on these units. Should win soon enough. Go into like a cinematic view. See how it looks. Zoom in on the front. Now a couple of people keep telling me to get these mods that improve the combat. Now I don't believe they improve the combat because the animations are very, very out of place when you put those sort of mods on. Here we're just going through the meat grinder and we're going to end the battle there. Decisive victory. We did lose one man or one unit of men and we nearly lost another. So 407 losses for us and 1275 for them. Not the cleanest of battles I've ever had. It's mostly because there was like boats involved. That's why I don't like siege battles or sea battles. Go ahead and occupy this. I forgot to sack that. Goddamn. Never mind. I'm gonna convert these places. Get a shrine of Rosmerta. This building can be downgraded.
Warriors all.
I'm gonna make him into a commander.
Hail to the mother.
We also need to think about recruiting some more sword band at some point, if we can.
Yes.
But with Alelia being ours, I'm just going to finish off this navy with my own navy. Just auto-resolve that with an aggressive stance, and that should sink it, because we've already attacked it this turn. There they go.
Yeah! We still have a win.
Job done there, we've got naval tradition. We're going to increase melee attack skill for assault ships.
I live to serve.
Now we just need to find a port where he can get his men back up to scratch because they've taken quite a few losses. Right, next we need to attack Consentia.
Ready for
That's what we're going to do. Now they have literally no men, so I'm just going to auto-resolve this with protective stance, and that'll give me 99% remaining. I can probably get away with sacking and occupying this. That's what I'm going to do.
Is there nothing else?
Sack it and then occupy it.
Thirsty for battle.
Cool. And then we can change these buildings around. We've got to repair all this lot. We need to start converting some of this stuff. I'm going to convert one of them to a chieftain's hold for the happiness. And the other one I can't change for now because I don't have the money. Same with everything else. Okay. So that'll have to wait for next turn. Now we got this navy or army coming in to attack Karanas. Now he went on to land to attack, so that's good for me. I don't actually have any ballistas in this army, however. So what I'm going to do... I don't have many men. I think I might just attack this on the battle map. I can run through some boiling oil. It's fine. My men should survive. Let's go and assault this on the battle map. Okay, let's start the deployment. Choose which gates we're going to run through. I'm probably going to run through two gates.
Spears.
And then here. And then we get the other lot of men over here. With the last two sword band. Okay, did I pick the wrong sword band there? I think I did. Keep the skirmishers on this side. We'll keep the cavalry over here as well. Start the battle.
Ready.
Get a couple of men to run up and burn down the gates. I'm not sure how many you can have burning down the gates at the same time, so I'm just going to try three now and see if that's any quicker than using two. We'll start moving up the other men behind. There's not many men defending. It's just a matter of whether I can actually get through the gates or not, because if they have boiling oil, then I'm kind of screwed in a lot of ways. It will just kill a lot of my men. I won't necessarily lose the battle, but I'll just lose a lot of men. There we go, charging up to the gates. Their reinforcements are coming in over here. They have Triarii and some levies. Yeah, they do have oil. You can see it in brackets. Gatehouse with oil. So what I'm going to have to do is just kill this unit straight up. Otherwise, I will pretty much lose this battle before it begins. Getting through two gates will help a lot, though.
Fierce!
That gate's already burning down, so is this one. 12% fire damage. The gate damage is 42%. Doing well. Hold on, man. I'm going to send one unit through at a time so that they don't get all burned to death by the same pot of boiling oil. I think it does take a little bit of time to refresh. We've got 87% gate damage, 90%. Let's get the men straight through and kill this Astarte. Right, here we go. And you can see the boiling oil coming down now. That's going to kill off a lot of my men as they run through. But with any luck, we can just break these units.
Back. Live to fight another day.
And yeah, get the men through the gate so they don't just stand underneath the oil like they are doing. Like idiots. We've got one unit in here, slaughtering all of the enemy men. And now we can just charge the rest through.
Back. Live to fight.
Hopefully. Stop them pouring oil on me. There you can see. It's just horrendous, that oil. Let's get some men up onto the walls to kill the levies. I'm going to keep the other two units within the gate.
Ancestors, honor us. Get running.
Okay, time to get these men through. Do it one unit at a time.
just so that I don't suffer the same fate.
See, look how horrendous that oil is. It just melts your men as you run through.
It's actually ridiculous how OP that is. But it's good because it basically means that people can't just run into your settlement anymore. I don't have it teched myself, so. Because the AI never seems to attack me properly. But I think as soon as you sort of neutralize it, it should stop pouring oil. I'm not sure how that works, so I'm just going to get the rest of these men out. Running them back through the oil. And wait until it's captured and then get the rest of the men through. Alright, that's done there. Shouldn't be pouring oil on me anymore. Let's run and take out the other army that came on the boats. Alright, let's get the rest of the men through. And if that oil comes down, I'm going to be mad. No, it didn't. Thank God. Okay, we're good. We're good, guys. Get our skirmishers to just run up onto the walls. And what we could have done, we could have maybe gone through this gatehouse. But I don't think it would have made much of a difference because that still has oil over there. Gonna get the cavalry into the settlement. See what we can do about taking out the rest of these units. So I'm gonna run straight into the levies. We kill them all. Not exactly sure where their triarii are.
Men are wavering.
Seems that they might be falling behind a bit. Spear band unit has taken a hell of a beating. It might be the first unit I've seen route in a long time on land. Because obviously some of my men did route in that horrible siege battle. Sword band. Hopefully though with some backup they won't run away. We can just keep running through all these units. It's always fun. Just a little massacre going on. Tell them to attack the last unit. And then we just wait. So we're capturing this sector. Gonna capture the gate over here. Doesn't do anything to us. I don't think it can, but doesn't matter. And the last levy unit, nearly dead. Let's go charge that. It's very low on morale. After taking a few casualties, they should run away. And there we go. And we just got to find the triarii. Cavalry charging into the settlement to capture their capture points. Oh, there's the triarii running all the way around the outside, as you do. We've won this day, decisive victory, 441 losses, mostly from the boiling oil, and they lost 664. And that pretty much means the Romans are dead.
You have further orders?
Sacked it. Gonna occupy it now.
Ready for orders.
And make him into a commander. Good job. We can set these up to repair. Doesn't look like I have the money to repair the main city. But we're minus 47 this turn. And I think I've pretty much wiped out both the Etruscans and the Romans in one fell swoop. They obviously still have some navies left, which I'll have to deal with. But their homelands are gone. I think we did pretty well today. So the Gaetuli are going to stay alive for another episode. But this time, I think we We hit the map hard. We took 2-3 provinces in one turn. Nice. Okay, so that's going to be it for this episode, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye.